how to relieve a gout attack. Gout is the most common form of inflammatory arthritis. It affects roughly 9.2 million adults in the US alone. This is equivalent to the population of Israel. Some of the most commonly affected joints include the big toe, the finger joints, the ankle, and the knee. And during acute gout attack, even the pressure of the bed sheet could cause you significant pain. Pain could last anywhere between days to weeks, but it usually peaks around 12 to 24 hours after a gout attack. There are two types of treatment for gout. Treatment of the underlying problem, the actual cause of gout, hyperuricemia, or the treatment of the immediate symptoms, pain and inflammation. In today's episode, we'll provide you with strategies to best manage the immediate symptoms of your gout attack. If you'd like to learn more on how to manage the actual cause of gout, then make sure to check out this video. Anti-inflammatory medication are considered first-line therapy. The American College of Rheumatology has recommended three different types of medication to treat your inflammation. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medication, such as ibuprofen and naproxen, are commonly prescribed to reduce pain and inflammation. Possible side effects include stomach ulcer, headaches, and dizziness. Colchicin is another type of anti-inflammatory medication. Its side effects include diarrhea, nausea, and stomach pain. Glucocorticoid is a type of corticosteroid used to reduce inflammation. They can be administered orally or through injection into the muscle and joint. Possible side effects include an increase in the blood sugar level, osteoporosis, and suppression of the immune system. The American College of Rheumatology has recommended early intervention for the management of a gout attack. A medication pocket strategy is often recommended for individuals who are able to recognize the early signs of a gout attack. Which medication to choose from will depend on your personal factors, such as your comorbidities and your past experience. There are a number of non-pharmacological therapy for the management of an acute gout attack. Topical ice is often recommended to reduce pain and inflammation. You could wrap a pack of crushed ice with a white towel, then apply it to the painful area. You could do this for 10 to 15 minutes at a time and several times a day on an as-needed basis. But to avoid ice burn, it is essential that you avoid having ice in direct contact with bare skin. Hydration is also important. By increasing your water intake, we can increase urine output, and this in turn will help the body's removal of uric acid. The recommended daily water intake for females is 2.7 liters, males is 3.7 liters. A special type of exercise is effective at reducing swelling and pain. This type of exercise will activate the skeletal muscle pump. Through muscle contraction, the veins situated between the muscles will be squeezed, and this will facilitate blood flow back to the heart. Imagine having a gout attack affecting your big toe. You're going to notice increased swelling around the foot. And to reduce that swelling, we need to activate the calf muscle pump. And we can achieve this by moving your ankle up and downward. As you move your ankle downward, you can notice your calf muscle getting smaller, contracting, squeezing the veins situated between the two halves of the calf muscle, facilitating swelling back to the heart. To make this exercise even more effective, place a pillow underneath the foot. By placing the body part with excessive swelling higher than the heart, we can use gravity to our advantage and facilitate removal of swelling back to the heart. The use of a mobility aid could also be helpful. Its primary purpose is to offload the affected limb, allowing you to maintain your independence and mobility. The selection of a mobility aid will depend on several factors. If your symptoms are severe and walking is impossible, you may find a walking frame to be helpful, as they can completely offload the affected limb. If you live in a townhouse with multiple stairs, you may find a walking stick to be more appropriate. The immediate symptoms of a gout attack could be managed through medication, hydration, exercise, topical ice, and the adoption of a mobility aid. By the end of the year, we'll release a self-management program designed for individuals living with gout. This program will not cure your gout, but it will be effective at reducing the frequency and intensity of your gout attack. If you like today's video, make sure to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.